my distinct honor to welcome you to the first Veterans Affairs Mayoral Candidate Forum. I'm here to introduce, first and foremost, the Chair of the American Legion War Memorial Commission, Paul Fox, who will be moderating. We have several commissioners here today. If you would please stand up so the crowd can recognize you. From the back, over here, myself, and other ones. So today's format will be one that follows a four mayoral candidate format. Each of them will have 10 minutes to speak. Paul Fox will be moderating the entire thing. All four candidates will get the same four questions, and all four candidates will get the same amount of time. So without further ado, for the sake of time, I want to make sure that we get kicked off on time with the first mayoral candidate, Angela Alioto.
Veterans Affairs Commission and are based on the State of the American Veteran, San Francisco Veteran Study done last year by the University of Southern California. And a 10-minute buffer for follow-ups or in case you run out of time. Timekeeper has been assigned, is sitting right here. He will be giving the final 3 minutes, 2 minute warning, and time's up. So, ready to roll? Thank you so much.
Yeah, is this, can everybody hear me or is it better without the mic?
Better with the mic.
Okay. First of all, so I have 10 minutes. I always have to remind myself because I am so passionate about the issues that I'm running for mayor on that I tend to go over the time limit. And then when he says time's up, I go, oh no, it can't be up already. As most of you know, I'm a born and raised San Franciscan. I've been three generations. My grandmother was born in North Beach in late 1800s, and my father was born in North Beach. So I'm three generations San Franciscan, and I was, of course, born here. I have four children and five grandchildren. I have, for the last 18 years, I'm a civil rights trial lawyer, which means that I have defended in the courtrooms of America people who have been discriminated based on their religion, their disability, their race, national origin, age, sexual orientation, gender. I have represented many, many vets in my life as a trial lawyer, but as a supervisor and as president of the Board of Supervisors, I was the legislator for the vets during the, 1989 to 1997. It's always been a great honor to me to represent the vets. And of course, during that time, we had the situation of the vets coming home from Iraq in 1991, going to Iraq, coming home from Iraq in 1991, and the situation of just having the new the new homeless population increase so rapidly, and so much of it had to do with the vets and how we took care of post-traumatic stress, how we took care of mental illness. So I was the chair of the health committee for 8 years. Even when I was president of the Board of Supervisors, I was the chair of the mental health committee. I created the Mental Health Advisory Board. You know, I tell my juries all the time when I'm in closing argument that there's a very, very fine line between good mental health and bad mental health. And you have to be there for the person to help them to make sure that that fine line doesn't get crossed. And we in public life have a great opportunity to help people when it comes to mental illness. We have never funded mental illness properly, never. In the 2000s, I did the 10-year plan to end chronic homelessness. I met with the Veterans Affairs Secretary of at the time was Principe. I said that in an Italian way. I'm sure you all say, how do you all say it?
Principe.
Principe means prince. And so I used to meet with him all the time in Washington, D.C. And for the 8 years from 2004 to 2012, we received more federal funding. funding from Veterans Affairs, from the Health Department, from Mental Health, Veterans Affairs. We even received homeless funding from the Post Office. The interagency that deals with homelessness has over 62 federal agencies. So in other words, homelessness isn't just about health. Homelessness isn't just about veterans and just about mental health and just about the things that we believe that it's just specifically about. It's about the Post Office. It's about transportation. It's about just about every different agency. So the interdepartmental agency that we worked with from 2004 to 2012 funded San Francisco more than in any time in the history of our city. So let me tell you a little bit about that plan, because I'm very proud of that plan. That plan worked. The 10-year plan to end chronic homelessness was a stellar, stellar success. And it ended in 2012. It ended when Gavin Newsom was to be lieutenant governor, and the new administration started, and then tech started coming to town in order to fill up the positions and the employment. So that's when it ended. But let me tell you, from 2004 to 2012, we housed 4,632 chronically homeless. That means people on the street from 4 to 6 years. Ladies and gentlemen, do you know how hard it is to house someone who lives on the street that long? They are embedded on the street. That is their way of life. It is very hard to convince them to come in off out of the street. And at the time, a whopping 38% of the 4,600 chronically homeless were our vets. Our vets. I gave speech after speech